Hello and welcome to MetroArts. I am your host, Larry Wallace. Here on MetroArts, we highlight some of the best in the business, from fine artists, photographers, and performing artists, to cinematographers and musical artists, all from the Metro Detroit area. On today's show, we're celebrating 20-year anniversaries of two key art organizations in Detroit. We'll check in with Ballet Renaissance, now in its 20th year, and feature two dance performances. The powerful jazz sounds of the Dale Grisa Quintet will fill our studio. But let's begin with a video overview of the Sphinx Organization, also marking its 20th year.
The perception that the talent isn't out there within communities of color is so deeply false in classical music.
Wow, drop the mic. There are millions of kids like this in this country who do not have the resources to become everything that they could be. But fortunately, these programs are doing the job that the bigger society fails to do.
Sphinx's mission is transforming lives through the power of diversity in the arts. And we address the issue of lack of diversity and inclusion through a sense of a pipeline. We have overture program replace violins in the hands of young people for the first time.
I definitely believe that the Sphinx overture program has made a difference in this community.
The Sphinx competition is our flagship program. It's a wholesome approach to musician development that goes beyond the competitive mechanism.
Sphinx Connect is the epicenter for artists and leaders in diversity, devoted to the issues of inclusion, leadership, and career advancement.
We have Sphinx Symphony, which is a professional, all African-American and Latino orchestra. And then we have the Sphinx Virtuosi, which is an ensemble of soloists that performs across the country, everywhere from Carnegie Hall to Harris Theater in Chicago, and really communities beyond.
I think the Sphinx organization is so incredibly important. It tries to achieve in our society an equilibrium of people who are incredibly talented and motivated to be part of every aspect of our society.
Sphinx has done tremendous work over its first 20 years. And I think that over the next 20 years, Sphinx will truly transform the lives of millions of more people.
Our first guest is the Director of Artist Development for the Sphinx Organization, Stephanie Matthews. Welcome to MetroArts.
Thank you for having me. It's good to be here.
So we get such a clear understanding of Sphinx and what it stands for through that video.
Absolutely.
Can you tell us, how did you get involved with the organization?
I started my involvement with the organization back in 2004. Mm-hmm. I was a violinist and semifinalist in the Sphinx competition. And from there, I was a musician in the Sphinx Symphony Orchestra. I performed with the Sphinx Chamber Orchestra, which is now kind of the Sphinx Virtuosi, the mm-hmm. conductorless 18-piece ensemble. Mm-hmm. And a few years ago, maybe about 4 years now, they brought me on to do some administrative tasks. Mm-hmm. So I started as artistic coordinator and then Sphinx Symphony Orchestra manager. And now I am in this new role as Director of Artist Development.
And tell us about your current role.
Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. So my responsibilities include managing and overseeing the Sphinx mm-hmm. Soloist Program. So all of the winners of the competition, past and present, mm-hmm. Are part of our soloist roster. And what we offer are opportunities, you know, for them to perform with orchestras. Yeah. So I kind of oversee and kind of manage that mm-hmm. And kind of cultivate, you know, in terms of career development for mm-hmm. those soloists. And I also have taken over the responsibility of running and kind of managing the Sphinx competition, yeah. and also overseeing and managing the logistics of the Sphinx Virtuosi Tour.
Okay, and now 20 years is a huge milestone for the
Absolutely.
Organization. The founders have actually received numerous awards, mm-hmm. including most recent, the 2017 Human Spirit Award. Yes. Tell us about the legacy of the organization.
Yes, so Aaron Dworkin is the mm-hmm. founder of the Sphinx Organization, and it kind of started when he was a student at University of Michigan. Mm-hmm. And he started to notice the vast underrepresentation of yeah. Black and Latino musicians in professional orchestras. Mm-hmm. So he started, you know, kind of asking questions like why? Mm-hmm. And he launched the Sphinx competition as a way to identify top talent. And like I said, I participated in the competition yeah. as well. And that kind of bloomed into something much bigger. And now we have lots of programs that we offer. You know, Sphinx Connect was new this year
yeah,
for Sphinx sure. 20. So, mm-hmm. you know, we're definitely doing well, and it's really incredible to see what Aaron's vision has created,
yeah.
you know? And Afa, who is now our president, mm-hmm. she has just done a really great job
yeah.
with, you know, kind of
For sure.
stepping into mm-hmm. the role, and just not only just from an administrator's perspective, you know, but also as a musician,
yeah.
because I've been directly impacted as well. And it's just, it's really an honor
Yeah,
to work
for sure.
with the Sphinx organization
yep.
because they are really directly impacting lives.
Right, for sure. It's come a long way.
Absolutely.
And where could people find out more information about the organization?
Well, you can find out more information on the website at www.sphinxmusic.org.
Mm-hmm.
And then for the social media, you know,
yeah.
Twitter fingers, you can check us out on Twitter mm-hmm. at Sphinx Music, which mm-hmm. is the Twitter handle, and also on Instagram, which is at Sphinx Org. And we also have a Facebook page, so you can look up the Sphinx Organization on Facebook
okay,
as well.
Great. Well, I want to thank you so much for being here. It was
thank
a pleasure
you so
interviewing
much.
You.
Thank you.
You're watching Metro Arts, produced at the Midtown Studio at Wayne State University. In our checking in segment, we have three guests from Ballet Renaissance, less featured in our second season. Welcome, guys.
Thank you.
So you guys want to start by telling us a little bit about Ballet Renaissance?
Sure. Ballet Renaissance is a nonprofit 501c3 organization founded originally by Brianna Furnish to provide education in classical ballet. It's currently directed by Brianna and also by Radha Kokoschka. We now have two sites, the Detroit site and also a site in Colorado in mm-hmm. Estes Park.
Yeah. And how did you all get involved in the organization?
Well, I myself came to Ballet Renaissance in 2011, mm-hmm. actually at the recommendation of a colleague of mine that I had danced with as a child, who was at the time a Wayne State student in 2011. And she said, you know, this is the best organization I've ever danced for. So I actually came to take classes for myself. And that was at the time that we were opening the Colorado expansion. Mm-hmm. And Roddick had a choreography job in Switzerland, actually, so he knew that he was leaving the country and asked how I would feel about substitute teaching for him.
Yeah.
And I just sort of ended up loving it, and this organization, you know, has been a perfect fit, so I stayed.
Okay.
Well, I am new to the organization and to Detroit. I just moved here last year. And the neighborhood, I moved into a couple of the parents that have been with Ballet Renaissance mm-hmm. for years were my neighbors. And
yeah.
they kept telling me about the organization and saying that I should look into it and maybe mm-hmm. it's somewhere that I would like to teach. And they were looking for an outreach teacher last season. Mm-hmm. And I taught an outreach class and then now I'm at the Central site.
Great. Yeah. How about you, Bill?
And I got involved, one of my colleagues wife was a teacher in Ballet Renaissance mm-hmm. in its earlier years, and I'd come to some performances at my friend's invitation, and then mm-hmm. he informed me 8 years ago already that they were having an adult class, and I should take it. He persuaded me. He since dropped out, but he also had three
yeah.
children to take care of,
mm-hmm.
But I've become addicted to it and love the organization. Since
yeah.
then, also besides taking classes, I'm also on the board of directors
oh, wow.
and help support the outreach program.
Oh, wow. So the organization is celebrating its 20th year anniversary. Why do you think Ballet Renaissance is so successful?
I mean, I think that there is a great spirit of community here. Being a nonprofit organization, you know, Ballet Renaissance belongs to nobody, but Ballet Renaissance belongs to everybody. You know, so everybody gives a little bit, and that little bit adds up to something very special.
For sure. And Bill and Lisa, you guys are going to be performing for us today.
Yes,
can you tell us a little bit about that?
We're performing an excerpt from a performance that was done last June at the Charles Wright Museum as part of our spring series. Every year, the Ballet Renaissance tries to feature a composer of the year. The composer this past year was Gershwin, so we did a nice choreographed version of An American in Paris.
Yeah.
So Miss Lisa and I are participating in that.
So Shirel, you actually choreographed the piece that we are about to see next. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, it's a Scott Joplin piece, and we've been working on bringing joy into their technique and dance. So the piece, to me, symbolizes springtime and how things are fresh and new, and that's what we are exploring in the piece.
Right, I'm excited to see it. And where could viewers find out more information about the organization?
Well, the best way is probably to visit our website. That is www.balletren.org. Mm-hmm. You can also check us out on Facebook, or for those of us who do not have internet ability, the phone number that you can call for more information is 313-469-0694.
Okay, well, I want to thank you all for being here today. It was a pleasure interviewing you. Up next, we'll see two performances from Ballet Renaissance. You're watching MetroArts on Detroit Public Television. The individual musical talents of our next five guests are superior, but when they come together, it's pretty amazing. Here's the Dale Grisa Jazz Quintet on MetroArts Detroit. Mm-hmm. Hello, Dale, and welcome to MetroArts.
Thank you.
You want to start by introducing members of your band?
I do. My name is Dale Grisa. I play piano in this group. To my left is Bobby Strang. He's a saxophone player. Mr. Chris Kurzawa on the guitar. Mr. Quentin Joseph on the drums. Yeah. And Takashi Iyo on the bass.
Hey, guys. So you want to start by telling us a little bit about the song that you just performed?
Yeah, that was one of my originals. It's called Por la Mañana. And if I'm interpreting correctly, it means it more or less means tomorrow morning. But I originally wrote it when my kids were really little, and it was kind of dedicated to them. First thing in the morning, I wanted to write a really frenetic song that was like, you know, that kind of explained how I felt when, you know, my feet first hit the floor and the kids were running around the house. I mean, all these guys have kids. Everybody can relate to what that's like. So
yeah,
that's where that one kind of stemmed from.
Yeah, for sure. So. Now, I understand quite a few of you guys have ties to Wayne State. Tell us about that.
We do. I think three of us are Wayne State alumni, right? Yes, I was, you know, in the jazz department in the late 80s, early 90s, as was Chris, was there also, got his master's degree, and Takashi also is a graduate from the music school there also. So
go Warriors.
We're all products of Wayne State. Yeah, we love the music school there. It was amazing. You know?
Okay. So. And you guys are going to be performing another song for us today.
Tell us
about that song.
We are. That one was written by Bobby. I'll let him tell you all about it. So.
Oh, this song's called Kenny's Killin'. It's my nod to Kenny Garrett. I wanted a song where all three of us played the melody, so the melody echoes itself around. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a contrafact over a tune he wrote called Wayne's Thing.
Yeah, and how would you characterize your music?
Boy, that's a tough one. We're kind of a modern fusion band, which is like, you know, a fusion of rock and jazz. But, you know, we're all steeped in various styles of jazz, from traditional straight ahead music to more modern styles.
And where could fans find out more information about your band?
You can connect with us on Facebook, you know, mm-hmm. So that's probably the best way.
Okay. Yeah. Well, guys, thank you guys so much for being here. It was a pleasure interviewing you.
Thank you. Appreciate
it. And now, here's the Dale Grisa Quintet with Kenny's Killin'. You're watching MetroArts on Detroit Public Television. We hope you enjoyed today's show. I'd like to thank our guests, Stephanie Matthews from Sphinx, all of the guests from Ballet Renaissance, and the Dale Grisa Quintet for being here today. Remember, you can watch any of our shows online at MetroArtsDetroit.com and find us on social media. I'm your host on MetroArts, Larry Wallace, reminding you to always support the arts and cultivate the talent in your community.